Ladies and gentlemen, I'm NoGad21. Welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 3. In the last episode, we met Patches! In the completely wrong order of events because I'm a fucking moron. And try to do things the wrong way. That's what I get for trying to be smart. So, today's agenda is to defeat the Deacons of... the Deep? Well, basically we need to kill the priesthood and the Cathedral of the Deep. And then we can basically grind up a bunch of souls to get all of Sigward's armor from Patches, so I can give him the Sigward, and then we can move on to a new area. That's my game plan for today. Fantastic. Also, I did a little research to figure out why the fuck NPC invaders ain't showing up when they should be showing up. Turns out that for some reason, the PC version, it has a unique little gimmick. That if you are on offline mode, NPC invaders don't show up for some reason, and apparently it was never altered at all, which would result in me having to go inside my configuration files and change a few things, which may end up borking my save file. So, no thanks. I will just accept the fact that I will never be invaded by anyone and move on. Does this mean I lose out on some equipment and gear? Yes, it does. But do I really care? Not really. The stuff I would get, I would never use to begin with. The worst part is, I could have used the 20,000 fucking souls that I got for getting this stupid fucking key. I could have used that to buy most of the gear from fucking Patches, but no, I had to get onto the rafters. Yes, let's parry the sludge, that's a good idea. Drank shoes. Yeah, let's just have. Ow. Could you? I'll just let... Yeah, I'll just... Yeah, no, this is fine. I'll just keep kicking at this guy's heels. No, and there he goes. Now I'll deal with you. Fortunately, we don't get crushed by his body, so that's a plus. Anyway, all that we get. Some more shit, and a large titanite shard. Large soul of an unknown traveler. Oh great, slug people. Another pale tongue for the collection. Wish I could move a lot faster. And here we get the Drang armor. Otherwise known as the Leowin set. Hello. Goodbye. Now we'll just roll our way to this. And we got the Drang Hammers. prepared hammers of the Drang Knights, descendants from the land known for the legend of the Linking of the Fire, Drang Lake. When the Drang Knights disbanded, they scattered across the lands of Sellswords. They quickly became known for shieldless, aggressive tactics that struck fear into the hearts of men. Spin bash, spin to win. The Drang set does not have a helmet. Armor of the Drang Knights, proclaimed for descendants from the land known for the legend for the Linking of the Fire. Fine protection that is both light and strong, having been reinforced with rare Gai Steel. Gai Steel? It's probably Gai Steel because of Gai. Actually, no, it's Gai Steel because of Geist. Gai Steel. The Drang Knights were once known as blah 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 blah. It's lighter than what I'm wearing. Much lighter, actually. Let's see what it looks like. I'm so glad this is a feature. Yeah, it's actually the Leia one set. Now we just need a proper headpiece. Huh, apparently the Thieves Mask has rivets in it for some reason. I don't know why. Well, at least I'm wearing... Really? Really, bitch? Alright, assholes, come here. I'll take care of you punks. Fortunately for me, this area right outside of this boss fog is perfect for getting all the souls that we'll need to get all of the equipment back from patches. Okay, attacking this guy should not... You were not supposed to get aggroed. You are not supposed to get aggroed, sir. You are not supposed to get aggroed at all. Fuck you. Right in your dick. And of course you don't drop anything, and you're not gonna refill my Estus flask for me, are you? Oh wait, yeah you are, there we go. That's a good little shitbag. Alright, dickhead, you're next. Okay. The greatsword roll onto his right side. Ow. And you give me nothing. Surprise, surprise. I'm already embered, and I'm down to 3 Estus flasks. This is gonna be a fantastic fight. Well, might as well summon up the boss fight. Summon up some friends here. Okay, let's get Henri of Astora and Horus. We need to do this to progress the questline for Henri as normally, because she's going to be useful for us later. At least I can still do this offline, otherwise I'd be fucked. Alright, Horus has been summoned, which means we can equip my... Steph, come on, you two, let's go. Apply the sword. Let's head on in. Welcome to the Deacons of the Deep, where we have to fight the fucking priesthood. Essentially, kill the glowing one. And these guys will practically respawn infinitely. Fortunately, we seem to be doing a pretty good job. Look at that, I even got my Estus back. Oh yeah, I forgot, you guys can also heal yourselves, Hephaestus. And here comes the main hope! Let's apply the buff here. No healing for you, idiots. Kill the Pope and the fight's over. We get a small doll and the soul of the Deacons of the Deep. Excellent. Okay, that's a boss down. Now we can head back to Firelink Shrine and go collect our reward. Okay, spending a shit ton of souls I could be using to level up. But instead, I need to buy some fucking armor. On the plus side, both Henri and Horus are now here in the Firelink Shrine.
Oh, and we meet again. We spoke before on the Road of Sacrifices. Henri of Astora. I'm well pleased to see you safe. We reached the Cathedral of the Deep, but Aldrich's coffin was empty. The man-eater must have left for his true home. The little doll in the empty coffin told me. Aldrich is said to hail from Irithyll in the Boreal Valley, an ancient fabled city. A pilgrim told me that the city lies beyond Farron Keep, and so becomes our destination.
Funny how the game from here on becomes a little bit more linear.
Aldrich's honest home is Irithyll in the Boreal Valley, an ancient fabled city. A pilgrim told me that the city lies beyond Farron Keep, and so becomes a...
Okay, Horus, you say anything? Of course he doesn't say anything. Ludliff! Oh, I'm one shy, damn it. Also, am I not being... Okay, we are good. Because you never know when you might end up finding out that you are fucked. I've been burned too many times via outside influences on my recording. With everything.
Aha, Valdrith, so...
Okay, so what can the Deacon's soul be made into? Let's see. A deep soul... spell and a cleric's candlestick. A candlestick used as both sword and catalyst, used for the worship by the Deacons of the Deep. Deacons, under the guidance of Archdeacon McDonnell, became both clergymen and sorcerers, guiding light. A candle provides a separate source of light, which reveals additional guidance. Yay, let's give a fucking useless weapon a useless miracle as a weapon art. Sorcery of Archdeacon Royce and his deacons, said to have been imparted to them by McDonnell of the Boreal Valley, fires dark soul dregs. Souls which swell from the deep pursue their target, drawn towards life.
Now.
Well, dark sorcery ain't what it once was, that's for damn sure, I know that for a fact. Cause that's a very fucking piss poor pursuers. Okay, is there anyone else here we need to talk to but besides Patches? No, and I am not going to be using this to get anything at all. Soul, the Deacons of the Deep, one of the Twisted Souls, seeped in strength. Use it to acquire many souls or transports, blah 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 blah. After Aldrich left for the Boreal Valley, Archdeacon Royce remained in the cathedral with the High Priest to keep eternal watch over their master's coffin. And I think we just killed Archdeacon Royce. Ah, the Patches Squad. Nice to see you.
Oh, hello again. Welcome to Patches' Boutique of Wonders. Can't resist it, can you? My sumptuous selection.
I had to kill a boss to get your shit, asshole. Okay, we need to buy the helm, the armor, the gauntlets, the leggings. Might as well buy the pierce shield, because why not? And we'll buy the ring, just because. Boost kick effect. An old ring with a seal depicting a horse's hoof. Boost kick effect. Unbreakable Patches adored this ring and the feeling that it gave him when he kicked his marks into the depths of treacherous traps, but suffered no shortage of ridicule from his associates for relying so heavily on the tired old trick. But who is the sorrier? The horse who knows only to kick, or the fool who approaches the old beast without thought? There's a lesson there. I'll take it. I don't need the rest of the thieves set at all. The wearer of this fine attire was admired by friends and enemies alike, for his skills were unmatched, and his heart was as true as gold. As his new owner, you have quite the shoes to fill. I can't tell if this is a reference to Patches himself, or as a nod to the Slayer of Demons. No, wait. It'd actually probably be a reference to Stockpile Thomas if it's a Demon Souls that nod. Demon Slayer Stockpile Thomas because of the Heart of Gold line. Eh, I'm probably thinking too much into it. Patches does sell black firebombs, though. And rustic coins. Patches actually sells some good stuff.
Thanks, good compere.
So long as you don't turn into a spider anytime soon, Patches, you can call me Compere whenever you want. Anyway. So level up some more. Well, actually, how many souls? Oh boy, I'm probably only gonna be able to level up twice. I probably actually should use these to upgrade my sword. Yeah, whatever.
Welcome, Hospi. Very well, then Tathekna.
Well, I didn't actually need to grind, which is a good thing, I suppose. Yep, only twice. I need to... Yeah, let's level up our attunement.
Farewell, Ashen. May the
I'll level up my endurance later. Probably gonna regret that. But Andre, my man, I need you to do some things.
Ah, just what need.
And we have just enough large shards to upgrade my sword. Nice. Okay, can I upgrade my... I can upgrade my talisman, I can keep my shield.
Pretty, I don't
want to see my work squandered. Let's see, do I have anything else to give to anyone else before I leave? Oh, the old doll, the small doll. Small silverwork doll depicting a young squire. In the legendary old city of Irithyll, situated in the Boreal Valley, the Pontiff Sullivan gave this doll to valued subjects so they might use it to cross the barrier when they return home. Listen carefully, and you can hear it say, "Wherever you go, the moon still sets in Irithyll. Wherever you may be, Irithyll is your home." Fitting. Oh yeah, I got the Firekeeper soul I could turn in. I can either give it to you, or I can give it to Irina. Giving it to Irina is pointless, though. I'll think about it. Anyway, let's go back and talk to Sigwerk, because we don't need to head to the Cathedral of the Deep ever again, unless I want to farm up the Cathedral Knights to get their stuff. See, at best, the only time I'm ever actually going to be wearing heavy armor is when I actually have high enough equipment load for that. For that, I need a lot more vitality. Hey, Sigurd, you still here?
I mean, quite a... maybe, I...
Hey, pal, I got your armor.
I, Siegfried of Katarina, salute you. With my trusty suit of armor, I'll be out of here in a jiffy. Until we meet again, comrade.
Rejoice!
No need to worry about me. With my trusty suit of armor, I'll be out of here in a jiffy. Until we meet again, my good friend.
Oh, how can anyone hate Sigurd? How the fuck do you plan to get out of there, though? I don't see a ladder. There's no rope with a bucket. Unless you tell me that your armor allows you to scale the fucking wall like fucking Spider-Man, I have no idea how the fuck you get out of this fucking well. Then again, I don't understand how you fell into the well in the first place, because I don't see how doing this kicks you in there, but whatever. I guess Patches has a better kick than I expected. Okay, well, this is a short episode. If I end it here, it's going to be a short episode. What the fuck? Okay, is there anything that I missed here at all in terms of treasure? Anything at all? Not that I can think of is the thing. How long have I been recording? Less than 15 minutes. Do I want to go back to the old video limit of YouTube? Well, not the first iteration of video limits, because that was 10 minutes. Good God, that was the Dark Ages. What? You know what? Dice gods. Let's see if you find this hilarious or not. Odds and evens once again, because I didn't expect it to be that quick. Fuck! Now I'm fucking frazzled. Wait, what the fuck? What the fuck's in that? What the fuck is that in my keyboard? What the hell? Is that a piece of food? Oh, come on. There we go. What the hell is this? Eh, whatever it is, I have to throw it out. Who needs tweezers? A simple knife will do the trick. Anyway, back to deciding my fate. Okay, odds? We ended here. Evens, we start exploring Farron Keep. Such as I did. Because I only went there beforehand to get some shit. Okay, roll. 18! Okay, the dice gods decided not to be hilarious and ended extremely fucking early today. Fair enough. Alright. In that case, to Farron Keep we go. Now let's see here. The first time we came here, I collected a scroll on the left. I did not collect anything on the right. On the plus side, I don't have to worry about an certain NPC invader fucking things up. Okay, we're gonna actually head to the left this time. And what's this? Purple moss clump, how fitting. Okay, if I'm gonna be wading through the fucking poison swamp, I need, actually, this is perfect, because I could swap this for this. Since this has... I don't need this right now. Since this has the... God damn it. Since this has the quick step weapon art, I can dash through the knee-deep swamp water. Okay, I need equipment that has high poison resistance. Oh, wow, the brigand said actually is very resistant to poison. Okay, hard leather. I bet if I bought the entire regular thieves set, I would be having a lot more poison resistance than anything I could currently use. Well, this is a hodgepodge of stuff that doesn't look completely atrocious. Iron flesh, huh? Well, I'm gonna get poisoned regardless, but at least at the very least, this will make me slide on through. And there's Basilisk in here. Great, my old nemesis. You want to know the best part about the quick step weapon art? Is that it works even when you run out of FP. Let's not get petrified, shall we? Come on, buddy, get out of the cloud. Nah, I interrupted you. Sucks to be you. Anyway, that takes care of them. Slide on through. Wrong side, that's a trap. Because if you keep the basilisk alive, if you end up going that direction, you get cornered. You want to head over here. Lord Sylvanine was soldier! Man, you people died horribly. Let's see, where are we? Okay, we're back. We're over here, beside this tower. I'm getting close to my objective. And here come the more basilisks. Fortunately, I'm now on solid land. Swig up. Idiot. Prepare powder. And that takes care of all the basilisks. And back here in this little cave. Hi, Elizabeth. You've seen better days. I think you're dead. The Golden Scroll. As well as the antiquated set. And I think someone has swiped this. Dress sewn in a long lost fashion. The laboratory embroidered ivory colored silk is imbued with ancient magic power. No protection is offered by this garment as it was never intended for battle. No shit. I think we found Dusk and Elizabeth. What happened to them throughout the years? Kind of a sad state of affairs, don't you think? Anyway, but the real prize was the additional scroll. A golden scroll chronicling the vast research of the Xanthus scholars. Give to a sorcerer to learn the arts of Ulusiel. In the lost land of Ulusiel, the sorceries orchestrated light and were said to shine in golden hues. So basically, this confirms what Xanthus does, and that the sorceries of Ulusiel still survive throughout the ages. Because Xanthus scholars research the golden sorceries of Ulusiel. Who would have thought? Slide on through. Oh, now I'm reminded of that stupid song from the skating rink. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. God, I fucking hate that song sometimes. Oh, Great. Big Fuck McGee. Hey, Big Fuck McGee. These guys are assholes. I'm just gonna walk on by. Don't mind me, boys. You could stay there and do whatever you want. And then we came full circle to the exit of the area. Because despite being a sort of maze-like swamp, this place is just a fucking giant circle. If you follow the wall, you'll eventually come here anyway. We actually need to come back, though. Let's see. Swig up. I don't need this right now. And let's take care of the infestation. Hi. Yeah, I can actually properly punch the slugs. Okay, I deserve that one. Don't you nip at my heels. Oh hey, an undead bone shard. We need that. Okay, if we're here... Ah, there's the ladder. Okay. The big treasures have been acquired inside of the keep, for the most part. Anyway, we come up this ramp. We find a bonfire, as well as the best place to farm up a Covenant item. Put these three chuckle fucks. And we keep ruins. We're actually gonna head back down to the ramp and head to... We're actually gonna head over here. Ignore you guys. Kill this moron. Let's see. Over there is another thing we need to light up the area. Anyway, we actually want to activate this ladder. Ow. Now to climb the Snake Eater ladder. I'm not kidding. I think this is the tallest ladder in the game. Well, there really is at least one of them. And it's the fucking tallest because we're above the goddamn tree line. There's another bonfire, but we're going to ignore that for now because we need to come up here. And there should be a crystal lizard nearby. There you are. There we go. And you give me some twinkling titanite. My thanks. Anyway. Hello, suspicious door. Dream Chaser's ashes. One of the more important ashes you need to grab. Umbral ash of one who dreamt of joining the Undead Legion. With this, the shrine handmaid prepares new items. In the end, the dream chasers who wandered aimlessly in the Rod Forest found a sense of fulfillment. Dying like a bitch, apparently. Because here we have a wolf. Who seems to be more dead than alive, but whatever. Right to the old Wolf of Farron, we get the Legion etiquette, and we can join the Covenant. And we now have the ability to be a watchdog of Farron. We obtained the proof of covenant. And if you give him wolf blood sword grass, we get a reward. Which is where those three chuckle frucks down below are required. Because this wolf will give you two rings and a sword. The rings are required for achievements, and the sword is useless. Anyway, we come with the lift. We are now on the bridge, or at least a section of it, that's between the undead settlement and Lothar Castle. And if we look down below, We can see all three towers that we need to remove the flyer of in order to open the door. Anyway, we come up here, we're gonna see a rather familiar sight. It's our good old buddy Stray Demon, who's looking a little bit monochrome. Let's not fight him for now, because at this point he is, shall we say, a little difficult. I'll have to come back later. Anyway, do a little bit of parkour platforming, and we now gain some extra treasure. Yay! As well as our first fucking offensive miracle. Large Titanite Shard, which I need. Another large shard. Hello, Wyvern. Hello, Lightning Spear. Sure takes a while to get a fucking offensive miracle, that's for damn sure. And we get the Dragon Crest Shield. I'm gonna use it. Because it looks cool. A knight's shield engraved with a crest depicting a dragon. One of the enchanted blue shields, the Dragon Crest Shield, reduces fire damage. And it can parry. Requires 14 strength to wield effectively. I don't care. Looks cool. Get back here, you cunt. Really, all that for a heavy gem? And this is how we get back to the other side. But I got a shit ton of enemies I need to kill first. Nice try. Alright. How many of you assholes are left? Two? Get over here, you fucking bandit. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And that's the third one that bites the dust. You're left, Lizzie. I hope you enjoyed being alive. Buddy, why would you try to swing back? Just hold up your shield. What's the worst that could happen? Ah, I could see why you would need to take the, fucking bat demons in order to get between Lothric Castle and the Undead Settlement, because this bridge got fucked up. Whether or not it was because Lothric got invaded by drakes, or wyverns, or whatever, or because the land literally had a fucking earthquake. Who can say? Drop it down here. And unfortunately for me, do I dare try to attempt finding the Stray Demon right now? I can try, but I'd probably get my ass handed to me because he's kind of tough at this level. Yeah, he can live for now. I'll come back here later. Although we did pick up an interesting pyromancy. Iron Flesh. Pyromancy that internalizes flame. Iron Flesh boosts damage absorption resistance, but significantly increases weight. And gives you old poise, by the way. Not advisable for walking in marshlands, perhaps resulting in its obsolescence in the Great Swamp. Doesn't really matter. Considering this fucking spell gives you the walking speed of a Tonberry. But your hits never get interrupted, and you have a shit ton of extra defense, so I think it's a whopping 60% increase. Well, let's find out. Let's take off all my armor. I should have zero absorption. And I look like a proper hollow now, that's for damn sure. Iron Flesh. Let's see how actually beneficial this spell actually is for absorption. We're at zero, we use this. 40. Okay, not 60 like I thought, but if we were actually equipping equipment. I mean, granted, we still take massive damage from fucking lightning, because, you know, iron conducts electricity. It doesn't last for very long. But hey, an extra 40 absorption? That is very useful in physical defense. Too bad absorption stacks diminishingly, and it doesn't last very long with high numbers, because people would probably not bitch so much about the loss of proper of old style poise that much if absorption worked a lot better. But semantics. I guess we go with I guess we can go with lightning spears for now, because I do not have that much gold pine resin, so having the ability to throw a fucking lightning bolt at someone might be useful. Keyword might be useful. Because miracles barely do any fucking damage in this game for some reason, I don't know why. Pyromancy does respectable damage, sorceries do respectable damage, but miracles don't for some reason, and I don't get it. Let's see. Would it be better to work from the back or the front of the swamp? Front of the swamp, because I still have treasure I need to grab there, too. Okay, back to the keep. Okay, alright, we're at the half-hour mark. Okay, then. So, let's see. Follow the fires or go into the swamp? We're gonna follow the fires. Extinguish three flames and opens the door to the wolf's blood. Or, extinguish three flames to gain access to the undead legion of Farron. Ow. Well, the watchdog boss fight at the very least. Ooh, we get the ragged mask. Good to go with the goddamn fucking old shit that we have. And what's this? Ooh, Titanite Shard. Hooray, I need that. I could have sworn I had V-Sync turned on. Line tears like that. Plunging attack! And unfortunately for me, farming up the slugs isn't a viable strategy to get upgrade materials in this game. I wish it was. It would save me a lot of time. Okay, there's an item up there we can grab in a bit. Ooh, another Titanite Shard. Well, let's go extinguish our first fire, shall we? Weird wolf goat demons. Which are obsessed with poison. Extinguish three flames and open the door to the wolf's blood. I think there's actually supposed to be four, because these represent the great lord souls. For example, this one depicts, well, the bed of chaos. Because woman praying with a tree? Anyway, extinguish three flames, and we can move on. Flame number one. fire up. Now, if I wanted to cheat this, since I have the other bonfire open in this area, I could just teleport straight to that and get the last two really quickly. And there's our destination. We need to enter that building in order to gain access to the boss, as well as the path that leads to the next area of the game. Because at this point, the journey is rather linear. You want to drop some poison moss for me? Nah, of course you don't. Should probably fix that. Okay, what's this? Ooh, rotten point resin. I can now poison my weapon. Too bad poison's fucking useless. Let's see, where am I? We are near the Dark Wraith, because I recognize you. Okay, pal. Come on, buddy. Get over here. You missed. Well, you guys definitely hate fire. Another Titanite shard for the collection. Another shard for the collection. Yay, poison. See, up here is... Ah, the great sword. You fucked that up, buddy. Okay, I almost fucked up my own death. Fortunately, I did not immediately panic. And over here is nothing, because this is not the bridge I thought it was. Okay, keep the thrall axe equipped so I can get through this shit in a speedy fashion. And I fucking hate poison. Okay, second fire. You are easily dispatched. Oh hey, more poison moss clumps, I need those. Here's Gravelord Nito because of the skeletons. Only one remaining, which is weird. You'd think there'd be four, because the four great lords. The kings of New Londo don't count. Well, actually, one other boss doesn't count either three does make sense, because there's only four great souls, and there's only three great lords for lore reasons. Nothing back here. Which is kind of a shame, but, alright, I'll accept it. Ah, and here's the bonfire, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, this place likes to circle on itself. You only get lost when you try to grab everything without knowing your surroundings. Okay, so I need... There's a talisman we can grab. Actually, there's a bunch of treasure we can grab. We just need to kill a lot of things to get to it. We also need to start killing the giants that are in here, that are in this hellhole. Because they're guarding and drop shit. Yeah, we'll just fucking heavy roll. Just fucking heavy roll. And here we have more purple moss clumps. Wonderful. Okay, nothing at all. I keep thinking I'm being followed. Ah, there's Big Chungus. And there's the second Big Chungus. But don't mind me, boys. I'm just gonna be hiding behind here. Yeah, that's right. Fuck off. I'll deal with you in a bit. And here we have... Why the four kings? It'd be more... It'd make a lot more sense for Gwyn or Seath here. Well, actually, Gwyn. Because Seath and the four kings have a shard of Gwyn's soul. Yeah, whatever. And that is that. Three fires dealt with. The path is open. Fantastic! What do we got here? Homeward bones, how kind of you. I don't really need those, but I'll take them. Excuse me. Okay, Big Chungus. You a huge boy. Ugh. I keep forgetting, you guys have less HP than I expected to. And let's just hear that. You gotta drop? Give me anything? No? Fuck you too. Fuck you too, asshole. Okay, now for Big Chungus number two. He's in the way. Oh wow, they actually connected? Impressive. Oh yeah. If you guys stand in fire, you have problems. I keep forgetting that these things have less HP than I expect them to. Why was there a sound glitch? Let's see, that is... And a poison. Great. Well. Let's get my shit. Shards. And over here is the classic knight set. Although this time it's named the Nameless Knight set. We can get the Elite Knight set from Henri. Which either requires us fulfilling her quest line or killing her. Tighten that shard, and as you can see, we're back here again. Like I said, this place likes to loop on itself. Which means this is the other significant treasure besides the three big boys over there. And here we have the Sunlight Talisman. Oh, Solaire. Yeah, pot of Estus soup. Don't mind if I do. Anyway. The Knight of Sunlight's personal talisman for casting miracles of the gods. The talisman bears the knight's own holy illustration, an emblem of his unwavering faith. Use of the talisman's skill fills the user with similar steadfastness. Temporary increases poise while casting miracles. Blah, 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 blah. Quit calling it poise, call it hyper armor, because that's what it is. And here's our first instance of Wolfblood Swordgrass, our covenant item for the Watchdogs of Farron. And not the worst thing to get in the world. I would argue Pale Tongues are easier to get because, well, for one, there's a lot more of them as drops, and two, you can farm up Dark Wraiths. A leaf signifying a duty fulfilled to the Watchdogs of Farron who stand beside the old wolf to ensure the serenity of those at rest depicts a sword grass leaf stained with dry blood. Long ago, the sword grass leaf quietly identified members of the Undead Legion. In the Rod Forest rests the spirits of warriors past. Their acceptance of and gratitude towards their guardians is expressed eloquently by the humble leaf. And we can get the rest of Solaire's armor too. So don't mind me, boys, I'm just gonna be sliding through. Alright. And I would say that has been a... How did you... I am not going to question how they died. It's probably a bad idea to do so. Let's see, from here, I could probably see those three douchebags. Yeah, because there's where we got our first scroll. And there's the three Chunguses over there. Let's rest. And this seems like a good place to stop. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been NoGuy21, this has been Let's Play Dark Souls 3. In the next episode, I kill the three Bungus Chunguses over there, collect that treasure, head through there, get the upgrade to my magic weapon spell because I can finally get it. And then I double check to make sure that I got everything that I need done, completed before we fight the next boss. But until then, thank you for watching, have a wonderful evening, and I'll see you all next time.